So in this position, what we want to do, if I can not get locked in a half guard, that's going to be ideal. There are things I can do to get my leg out if I have to. But what I want to do here is, and he's going to be kind of crouched in here. Maybe he has an underhook here that I'm fighting, and I've got this arm in tight here, okay? Now, what I need to do is get under his leg here, okay? Hitting this like a weave pass. This is why I'm really going to set this up from here, is just hitting this weave pass right here, okay? Putting pressure down on the knee right here, okay? He's most likely trying to sit up into me and get this underhook here, okay? If he's staying down, it's going to make my pass a lot easier here. I'll smash and come around. If he's sitting up into me here doing this, this puts me right in position for this cradle. Okay, all I'm gonna do is this hand comes under the head here, tight, and I'm gripping here in an S grip. Okay, when I say S grip, here, okay? In wrestling, I use the gable grip a lot for the cradles. For certain transitions in jiu-jitsu, this S grip is pretty handy, and also they can't try to peel the fingers or anything. So I'm here, I'm in the knee pit here, and I get my S grip, okay? And I'm staying tight. Now, if I just can get my leg loose here, great. Or if I already got it out in this transition, wonderful, okay? If not, I need to use my other foot to peel it off. Okay, I'm here, as soon as I get here, I'm going to pressure my chest into him, okay? So I got him stuck so he can't move too much. Okay, now, when this happens, I'm gonna circle to his head here. Now, circle in, catch this leg again. Just like that. Okay, now, if I just stay here, he can kind of move a little bit. What I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this leg here and kind of crunch him up. Okay, this makes this leg coming through so much easier. All right, now this leg can come over. All right, now, I want to just hang out here even when his leg's too long. So I just want you to walk. It's really easy because I got his leg all stuck up to his face. All right, now from here, once I have a good base, I'm going to keep his head controlled, okay? I'm going to release with my right hand. It's going to come around. It's not a really big movement. It's just coming around here. I'm coming under his head. When I come under the head, I spin to his back here. Now, exact same thing I did, but I'm hooking it here now, okay? In wrestling, I always try to get like over the arm here, get a little bit better position for like a pin. For this though, right here is just fine. All right, now I'm gonna circle up to his head. This is a good spot. You think, oh, he'll just leg press and just pop your arm at us. When you're up in his knee pit here, I can also scissor my elbows. Make sure you don't make them neither side of the face, you know, at least not in here, bam. Okay, but I'm here and I'm tight. Okay, he's stuck here for a little bit. Now from here, I'm gonna continue my transition. You know, I just went all the way around him here. I'm gonna set him up. Just like this. Okay, now what's gonna make this easy, if I stay here like this, this is very hard to get my leg around. I'm gonna slide my hands to here. Okay, as soon as I slide my hands, I'll just keep my elbows tight. This hook comes in, and I'm here. Now, what's he gonna do here? His chance of getting this leg loose is a lot better because I don't have my weight on him. So he's gonna kick that leg with all he's got. Now when the leg pops loose, when I feel that tension, watch what my hands do. Boom, this comes up, going for the choke, that hook comes in. Okay, he just made it really easy for me to lock right in. Another option we have, we're in this same position. And let's say he's pretty strong here or whatever, and I have a little bit of trouble keeping this leg in. Like I said, he might grip very well or something. All right. What I'm going to do is, if I feel his leg kind of going, I'm going to come up this way a little bit. Okay? I'm going to come up towards his head. All right. Now, this, I'm especially going to do this if he's pushing me away. If he's using this arm to like push on me here, like this, I'm definitely going to do this. Okay? So when I'm here, this angle is like this, when he's pushing, coming here, I'm gonna drop to my side. Here, this arm has, my elbow has to come over there, okay? Elbow comes over, and I trap his arm. Okay, now, my left hand, I don't want to shoot it as deep as I can. okay? You want the forearm
right on the side of the neck here. Okay, some people go way too far on this and hook it up, and it actually kind of gives a little bit of a pocket in there for his neck. Just a little bit of space, okay? You lift that forearm right on the side of his neck here, and it's gonna be a lot worse, okay? I'm gonna pull the elbow in, and I'm gonna get my anaconda choke here. Okay, now, to finish this, a lot of people too, they'll just fall over on their side and think that's the choke. I've got my arms hooked up, that's the choke. No, you've gotta get under their head here, okay? Kind of like you're trying to crank their head in. You can keep cinching this up as tight as you want. Okay, all I gotta do is get my torso here under his head and set in there. Okay, I can try to just do it from here, but I've really gotta get my body under his head. Now, if for some reason you can't get a good angle and it's not exactly right, I'm gonna take this leg and step over. Now, that is a done deal right there. That's very hard for him to, unless you just don't have it hooked up right, it's gonna be hard for me to get it. So sometimes when we're entering the guard here in no-gi, you'll have an opportunity to also work your cradles, okay? And especially if they're kind of crouched up, like they're trying to like butt scoot in and get close to your leg here, okay? I can snap his head down here, just like I'm going for like the guillotine, okay? But instead of going for the guillotine, I'm gonna reach under the leg and get my S grip, okay? From here, all I'm going to do is roll to my right. Here, just like I'm going to do a cradle. Like in wrestling, I would hook this leg here and try to get my pin. Okay? We're not wrestling. So here, once I get up like this, I'm going to release and chin strap here. Okay, so this hand catches his chin. We just rolled over, I catch his chin, I come back up, and I'm right here inside. Okay? With a good latch on his neck there. Okay, one, two, three.